Hello, I'm John Aldridge and I'm watching the Redman TV.
And that just sets it on your way sometimes, you never know. Anyway, we'll move on. Christian mentioned Reading. We're going to come on to the Reading preview. Before we do, I'm a little concerned about performance. So I've got three envelopes here, boys. Of the five of us in this room, I'm concerned that three people are going to let us down. I've written your names in there. So I'm going to put them there as some form of motivation.
Don't just go now.
Don't. No, I'm not saying your names in there.
The look on Charlie Adams' face when that happened, by the way.
Panto, Adam, yeah, and Darren.
And this was going.
No. It reminds me of the last day of school when they said, and there was this speech, and some of you will be invited back, and I've been told 2 days earlier that I wasn't welcome back at that school ever again. And I remember clocking eyes with one of my teachers, and we both pissed ourselves laughing. It's like, you know, and in this instance, it's like, Charlie, he knows, and so he's talking about me, isn't he? Yeah, he's probably talking about you, Charlie, most definitely. Anyway, we digress. We'll be talking more about being Liverpool, episode 4, later on the subscriber show, so do check that out.
Well, we've already spoken about episode 5, haven't we?
Yeah, Christian's already spoiled it to death. Like,
I don't know what happens in episode 6. We signed no one.
The exciting deadline day.
Except Donnie Darko, he's sitting there and going, what's going on? Is that it?
Yeah, amazing. Fucking bouncy climax of the fucking year, that way. And we get to relive it in high definition. Brilliant. Anyway, back to Reading. Chris, pressure's on. It's, look, in all seriousness, we've talked about this season, we've talked about the games we played. The first five games of the season, very difficult. We didn't get anything like we got pretty much the worst that we could have got from them, more or less. People started looking at the next five games and saying, right, this is where we need to start picking points up. Again, it hasn't quite worked out that way. But Reading, do you think this is the first of the season, the first genuine must-win game?
Yes.
I
really do think we've got. If we don't beat Reading, you're looking up and down the league table thinking, where are we going to win?
Yeah,
who are we going to beat here?
It's not an easy.
No, it's not an easy. But they're not as bad as they sort of have been in the league themselves.
I think that's it. We look at the league table. I think that you're right. There's no. It's such a cliche, but it's true. There's no easy games. Reading isn't an easy game, but if you can't fucking beat Reading at Anfield,
yeah,
what's the fucking point? Where are you gonna finish?
I think the Stoke game was a bit of a red herring, really, because Liverpool never done well against Stoke.
Mm.
So, you know, that was the wrong game at the wrong time. It was really, because you looked at the fixtures and you went, oh, two home games coming up. Yeah, but one of them's Stoke, and that's not the game that, you know, especially the way we, you know, they're really bad this year. So they're less effective and therefore harder to break down, if that makes sense. You know, Redden, as you say, you know, you're going to start looking at the table, and you know, I'm a firm advocate of that. You shouldn't really, the table should be published till about 10 games in anyway, really. But this will be this will be the 8th game. You're just wondering, well, how many points are you away from the
when
top
do we play QPR? Yeah. Is what you're wondering.
You know for a fact that they'll get me to Mark Hughes and they'll bring in Jose Mourinho.
Yeah.
You know, it'll be his first game at Loftus Road.
I'm a sad Neymar in January.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, there are no easy games, and especially it's a weird feeling, isn't it? Because do you remember when like Liverpool would turn up and you'd expect a 2-0 win? You can't do that with any game.
Well, so many times with the Breezes, and the people who I still don't get why people didn't like him, but those afternoons, you turn up to Anfield and it was just comfortable. You never got out of second or third gear, but you come home, you win 3-0.
You'd be more asked about what you're having in the ship.
Yeah, you know what I mean? It was done, you were watching a foregone conclusion. Whereas, Jimmy, look at it now. I've said a couple of times that in isolation, all the points we've dropped this season were all droppable points. Mm. Because they've been compressed into the start, it looks like a fucking disaster. Mm. But by all accounts, you've got to put that to one side. You've got to sort of, as Christian says, don't look at the league table and say, right, Reading, let's go out there and we've actually got to go and get that first home win.
Yeah, we've got to stop. There's got to be a point now where we've got to stop looking at how the team's performing. You know, everyone's saying, oh, look at the way we're playing well. You know, we can see the advancements. You can see Rodgers' stamp on the team, the formation, the style. It's all there. It's just the results, and results will come. The results have got to start coming at some point.
Yeah.
And it should be against Reading at home. You know, the next fixture.
Yeah.
We can't go on and on and on with this. There's got to be a point at some time.
It's the problem was is that, as you pointed out, Christian, fucking Stoke. I felt like we needed to just go and get a home win, and you'd almost forget that it's Stoke in some instances. I came away with the inescapable feeling that the longer we go without getting a home win, I don't know where it's going to come from. I don't know how we do it anymore. I've forgotten how Liverpool win at Anfield because I've not seen it happen enough.
In 2012.
It was fucking great wins.
Yeah, Chelsea and Everton. Yeah. But, you know, it's... Yeah, I would have rather seen Newcastle at Anfield than Stoke. It was one of those. It was, in hindsight, it was a really bad game to have because when it's a must win, they know how to grind, how to draw, you know. Yeah. It's a habit, isn't it? And it's mad to think at the back end of Kenny's caretaker reign, you know, swatting away Newcastle 3-0, you know, Birmingham 5-0. It all seems, you know, like the fortress was coming back. It's ironic that the one thing that Brendan Rodgers keeps on repeating is that he wants to make Anfield fortress.
Any day now.
Yeah. But I mean, 3 minutes away from a 1-0 defeat against Hearts.
Yeah.
You know, it's not just that, and it lost to Udinese as well, and it's just getting a little. You just that first win needs to come on the board because at the end of the day, after Reading, it's Everton away, Newcastle home, and Chelsea away. I think.
Sorry, no, if ever a noise summed up exactly what everyone else would.
the thing with the Everton thing is, if we don't get a result against Reading, that's one of those games where form doesn't matter. Mm. So we could pick up something at Everton. I don't think it's likely at the moment.
Couple
the
way we've been playing.
Yeah, yeah. Couple of red cards, very suspension, yeah.
But yeah, I do think Everton is a game that we could quite easily win.
I think that I've compared a couple of times already, this season reminds me very much of Rafa's first season, 2005, that you felt it was always that sort of two steps forward, one step back, one step forward, two steps back, and every good result was always followed by a soft defeat. And I really get to feel
good results.
No, because think about it. We've had the good results. You know, we had the Norwich result, and then it was tempered by the draw with Stoke. We've had a couple of good wins in Europe as well. You know, the one of the games against Young Boys. I mean, I know the shit opposition, but you only beat who you put in front of you, kind of thing. It's just that we basically, in order to keep that cycle going, we need to go and beat Reading, and then worry about Everton. Because if we lose to Reading, the pressure in that derby game is unbelievable, because then you have to win the derby. Mm. We need to start getting some wins under our belt, and that's where the worry is. And the thing is, Chris, I'll come to you. The thing is, I don't think there's going to be a question of Rodgers' position at all. I don't think that's under question. It's just that for our own sense of well-being, I just want to just win some fucking football matches.
It'd be lovely to see a win. Absolutely lovely. I haven't seen one since Gommel.
You've been on holiday. You haven't seen half the fucking shit that we've had to put up with, like.
But I miss going to Anfield and seeing a win and coming home happy.
Yeah, it's true. Christian, you mentioned it before. Obviously, Reading, they're not as shit as the table would suggest.
And they need to win as well. Yeah. This again, on paper, it's an easy game, but they really need to win. And McDermott's sort of. You know, they've got rich Russian oligarch there now, and he must be thinking, my job's in a bit of trouble here, because they can just hit the shop door.
Could be the next Neil Warnock.
Yeah, exactly. He doesn't want that. He's, by all accounts, he's a lovely fella, you know, and almost made me look at him and say he's too nice.
They
should
make the best managers, don't they?
Well,
no, I think the interesting point is, look at their form. It's a draw, three defeats, followed by two draws. The last game, 2-0 with Swansea. They're 18th in the league. Funnily enough, though, they've conceded, conceded 13, which is only very slightly different to us, who've scored 9 and conceded 12. And yet, amazingly, we think we're so much further ahead of them. They're 3 points behind us with a game in hand. So technically, they can, if they beat us and win the game in hand, they go above us, which is...
You're saying it's a 6-pointer?
It's upsetting you, mate, I'm telling you. And the thing, again, we had a look at some of the chance created, chance converted stats a couple of weeks ago, and we were saying how Norwich were in a false position, but Reading were actually pretty much where they should be. But they're not without danger, and Pavel Prebniak, try saying that three times fast, he's a danger man, isn't he?
He's a good player. He's a really good player. When Tottenham went to and got Pavlyuchenko, I always said they got the wrong Russian because he was in Sheffield in 2008. And I genuinely believe, because Pavlyuchenko was pretty poor in that sort of, if he was fit, he would have banged them in. He would have at least got them. Well, they might have got past Spain, but you know what I mean. He was a very good player, and he's just found a way to Reading, which is a bit of a bizarre move. But you know, they're compact and they play through him, and he likes that. You know, he had a decent time with it. Stuttgart, I believe it was Stuttgart. And I was surprised.
I miss you, Chris. Your encyclopedic knowledge. The German one doesn't really like it.
Yeah, it's a record signer, isn't he? 7 million. He can finish.
I can't believe Fulham didn't pick up though, because he had a 1-2 and he scored. I think he scored. It's written down in front of me. He got 6-12 for Fulham back end of last season, because they go on loan in January.
Funnily enough, no one actually knows. They think he went on loan with an option to buy. Or do you think that he got him on a... He was released by Stuttgart and got a 6-month contract with Fulham and then left Fulham. But he gave 7 million to someone.
I like Michael
someone's
Jackson too. Can I have a game?
I mean, the thing with Reading, their weakness is Ian Hart. Great for fantasy football because he takes corners and things. Not that I like fantasy football,
of course not.
But if you put Suarez on the right, he'll maim him.
It's such a shame. It was such a surprise. So many of these players are coming back out the woodwork. It's Richard Wright all over again, isn't it? Ian Hart back in the... Oh, I used to love Ian. I was the one player, a long list of players of the Premier League era that I wish Liverpool had signed in his
head. Liverpool needed the left back, wasn't it?
Good sort of. We signed Christian Ziege.
With you.
We signed Christian Ziege, and there was Ian Hart banging free kicks in from 35 yards as a left back, like, you know. Jimmy, how do you think this game is going to pan out then?
I dread to say. All the reasons we just discussed, do you know what I mean?
It's horrible. There's such an edginess, isn't there, at the minute, because of the fact that we're not killing teams off.
There is, and we're all being wary still of you know, Beckham, Brendan and the system and the ideas, the ideal and that, and give them time. And obviously, you know, the sensible fans out there will be giving them time. And, you know, it's not to say, right, we don't beef Reading now, you know, he's got to go, even though there is people out there already saying those kind of things.
No beds, we can't lend, but just... I know, Chris, it's not, you haven't been doing that under a false name or anything, have you? Like,
me? Yeah, Jonathan Jenkins.
Yeah, no, I take your point. The pressure's mounting, but we should just do them, like.
Hopefully so.
Do you remember when Juventus come to Anfield and we thought, well, we can turn them over?
Yeah.
No. Yeah. Do you know what? It's just that edginess, isn't it? And it'll translate to the crowd. And
it's one of them, isn't it? Go back to like the previous games at Anfield this season and like the other easy defeat. And I was like, oh, it's a Fiorentina.
Sorry,
it was
an
easy.
Yeah,
cut that.
Make sure.
Fucking legend.
It was one of them, and I'd been caught up in it all, thinking, oh yeah, but we played well, and then I was sitting there thinking, hang on, we've just been beat at home by Udinese.
Yeah.
It's Udinese, you know, they're not giants this area, do you know what I mean?
I don't know, I think people, we forget about that, and I think a lot of that comes with us being living, and we've been spoiled, and I think we still have that Champions League mentality. Is Udinese, we're a Champions League club. They were in the Champions League this season, albeit they fucked it up in the group stages. They've had a progression. They've been in the Europa League for the last couple of years. We were in Europe last year, and we're only in it this year because we won the fucking Carling Cup. Like, you know what I mean, and played 14 qualifying rounds to get to that point. But I do take your point. I just think that, as you say, it's next week we'll be laughing. Because according to the script, we're going to go out and we'll score early and we'll absolutely fucking snot Reading everywhere. it's just that at the minute, it just, you just, as you say, there's that uneasiness that comes with the fact that we don't know that for sure that that's going to happen.
Who's the ref?
That's a good question.
It's someone very new.
Oh, so
that's not his name. He's not like Eastern European.
I really thought you were going to pull that out.
No, but it's a new ref. It's no one sort of. I'm pretty sure it's someone.
They need to get some new ones. Yeah. Fucking, they're getting them banned left, right, and centre, aren't they?
Well, I don't know about the refs. I miss the old ones.
Like what, Ellery?
Ellery, yeah.
Paul Macken.
Dirk and Paul Dirk,
the old headmasters.
You talk to you like you were scum on the feet.
Thin and hair, wiry, pedophilic looks. Look like they'd kill you.
Roger Milford.
Anyway, we'll move swiftly on. Right, does anyone want to have a bash at naming Liverpool 11?
I'll have a go, like.
Go on, Chris.
Pepe Reina.
If you get it right, don't forget, you might be a spotter by the light.
I don't think you want my Twitter name.
Like. What's in them envelopes? It's going through your letterbox.
Right, I'm going to try and do. I'm Dunkin' Donuts, by the way, that's what my
Twitter
name's going to be. Andre Wisdom, Skirtle Agger, Johnson. I think we're actually going to change to a 1 and 2 with the midfielders this week. I think we're going to play Allen and then Shelvey and Sahin. Suarez, Gerrard and on the left, Sterling.
Wow. I don't think that's going to happen in a million years. But thanks very much for putting that out there. Let us know what your thoughts are on that. Do you think that's the line Liverpool go with? As I said, and we do this every week, it's because there's football currently being played as we speak. Steven Gerrard's probably just fucking broken his leg, or something horrific will have happened in the international break, which will fuck that up. You'll know, let us know. I could see that, but anyone want to counterpoint to that, Christian?
I think the back five is right. I think it'll probably be Alan, Gerrard, Sahin, Suso, Sterling and Suarez.
Yeah. I think that
maybe Asaidi is a random little shout. Yeah. I don't know if he's travelled. Morocco were involved in the African Cup of Nations qualifier, so I don't know if
did he score against Mozambique or something like that?
I've not scored against Mozambique, I don't
think. I've scored against Mozambique.
So
I've been on the beak. Sorry.
Completely different conversation. Anyway, move on. I don't know where it's coming from this week. Is that where you consummated your marriage? I think really. No, to be perfectly honest, I actually think that's the 11 you've named there. I think is our current first choice, our best 11, pretty much of who we've got available. It's just a question of whether Asaidi has done enough to get himself in, because you'd like to think that we can take Suso or Sterling out of the final line and give aside his first Premier League start to boot as well. So I think the option's definitely there. Score predictions then. Jimmy. Go on. If you wanna be negative, be negative.
I'm not being negative. 2-0, Netman.
Excellent. Christian, you've no qualms about being negative, I don't need to tell you. You're fucking realist.
1-1.
1-1.
I just think Ren needs a win as well.
Yeah.
And I can't see them losing again. I 1-1, maybe 2-1 with a jammy Suarez off his ass after he tries.
No, we've got Joe Cole on the bench to do that.
All right then, 3-1 then. No, 1-1 or a narrow 2-1 win.
Okay. Chris?
4-1.
Wow. Because you think we'll score goals, but we're still shit at the back, so we're bad.
Yeah, exactly.
I think we're going to win.
Plus, will that make our goal difference the same?
What do you mean? The
4-1.
Same?
4-1. Goals scored and goals conceded. Does it?
Fast math. No.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
4-1's a definite.
Fucking hell, Chris. Someone on the spot. You're the math whiz, like. No.
What was it? 9+4 and 12+1 or whatever, like, do you know what I mean?
Fast math. Hey, listen, none of this fucking exists. I might not be good at numbers, like, you know what I mean? No, I think 3-0. I think we'll again, I always qualify it like it depends entirely. There's so much pressure in Anfield, and we've talked about the uneasiness as well. If we get that early goal, much like Norwich, I just think we'll go on and wipe the floor with every team. Any team I think we can beat if we get the early goal and we dominate. It's just that the fear factor that comes with if you don't score after 25 minutes, particularly in a game that isn't like a massive competitive one, so the crowd doesn't really come pumped up for the Reading game. You know, the cop dies off after 15 minutes, unless something mega happens anyway. So I think we need that to happen, otherwise we might struggle. But fingers crossed. Happy, 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 upbeat and all that. Do let us know your score predictions. Are you feeling as negative as Mr. Christian Walsh? I hope you're wrong. I really hope you're wrong. I hope you feel guilty.
I think for Breniak, he's got the
moves like Jagger.
Yeah, Skirtle.
Impossible player as well.
Mackenough, yeah. He, do you remember when he ran through the defence and then he scored? Decade.
No, I choose to forget that.
Score?
No. Anyway, yes.
Liverpool overheading actually for that. You forget that.
Yeah. Oldham won big time. What was that the cup?
That was the cup. Benitez's last season, third round, replay.
Yeah, I had chosen to. Just
as long as Federici's not got a cape on as well, in goal.
No, it's not him, it's McCarthy now. Alex McCarthy, who's far better. Like, it was like.
Excellent. Yeah. Brilliant, there we go.
Can I change my score?
Fantastic, absolutely fantastic. So we'll leave that there on that wonderful air of positivity. So basically, as Christian put, they're a hard team. We do owe them one, but their goalkeeper's well better than last time. They need a win.
Otherwise, you've got to be positive. They got McKaylee Legitwood in the centre, holding. That's like using flour and water as glue. Like, it's
amazing. I love it, but that's. So this, we call it Ian Marshall syndrome, is that if you ever slag a player off and isolate him for criticism, it's generally when he has a fucking worldie. Like
what I've done for Kinchewski. He was playing a live game a couple of weeks ago and I was on Twitter taking the piss out of him, and then he scores a 40-yard belter, top corner.
Was
it a cross?
Yeah,
it could have been.
Cross shot Kinchewski. Anyway, we'll leave that there. If you're watching this segment on YouTube, I hope you've enjoyed it. If you want to watch more, we're on the Subscriber Show 2 hours this week. We've already talked about the this week's storm in a teacup, the Chang Jenkins affair, the new stadium announcements, talked about Lucas Leiva's interview, and we're going to go on shortly to talk about Being Liverpool episode 4, so do tune in for that on the redmentv.com, free for a month. If you like it, keep it. If you don't, fuck it off. Otherwise, it's £2 a month. We'll see you there. Anyway, gents.